Hello people, my name is Dan Mott and today I have a troubleshooting video for you. Let's talk about the error in window activation. That pesky activate your windows warning that you have on your screen despite using legit window from your company. Now, this is only one error of many, but you might find it difficult to fix without reinstalling windows. I am talking about error 0x80041002. The specific condition to this error is: number one, you are using volume license, which is generally called sometimes called enterprise license or bulk license, that you get from your institution, your workplace, your company, or your school. Number two, you have tried to reactivate the Windows using the license you have, and it shows the error code 0x80041002 in activation UI. This is optional, but if you also run slmgr command on console, it will show the same error. If these three conditions are true, keep watching. There will be a fix in this video. Now, before we talk about fix, we have to understand what this error means. This error means the activation service cannot connect to the activation server. What can happen to prevent activation service from connecting to activation server? Number one is firewall, which means there are someone or some program that blocks the traffic, but generally we don't block window activation service. Who would do that, right? If you are sure that your firewall does not block the activation service, there might be some virus or some malware that gonna prevent the activation service from working properly. And then there is the corruption of system file. Now, before I talk about the fix that I discovered, it is safe to perform the common fix first. By generally when we have this kind of problem, we will start by scan everything and fix everything that can be fixed automatically. So we will start with that process. First, scan for malware and virus and clear them out, if any. Alright, use your antivirus and anti-malware program and scan and clean everything. Restart your PC and see if it works. If it works, done. If it doesn't, proceed to step 2. Step 2 is you will use sfc command in console. To scan for system file and fix them. To do that, press window button on your keyboard, type down cmd to open console. Next, type down sfc spacebar / scan now. This will scan your system for any corrupt file and fix them automatically. Alright? If it doesn't work, you can make sure that you done command prompt in administrator privilege, which can be done like this. CMD, you see it right here, run as administrator. If you run this, it will prompt and you say yes, and then you type down sfc/scannow to scan and fix your system file. Restart, try again. If it still shows this particular error, we'll use the next one, which is DISM tool. Same thing, open command prompt in administrator mode, and then you will type down a command like this. First, DISM/online/cleanup image/check health. You press enter, you wait for it to finish, and then you type another command which looks almost the same, DISM online cleanup image, but instead of check health, you will use scan health. Wait for this one to finish again, and then you type down, you run the third command, which is restore health. All right. After you run these three commands, restart your PC, try activate window again, see if it works. If it still doesn't work and it shows the same thing, this error code, proceed with the fix that I will show you in this video. If all the steps so far doesn't work, it means that you have some corruption in your WBEM, which is a web-based enterprise management. This is why this particular error happens with volume license. Now, how can we fix it? First, you go to your computer, drive C, Windows, system 32, and you find WBEM folder. Go into WBEM folder and go to repository. You will find a files like this. Now, chances are when you come to this directory, you will not only find these five files, but you will find another file that might look like this. All right. Now, if you see something like this, chances are your system has some corrupt file, and you can restore it easily by delete all these files, and the next time your window boot up, they will restore itself. All right, but you have to get rid of all these files. But if you try to delete them right now, it will not allow you to delete these files, because Windows are actively using these files. We have to stop Windows from using these files by going to service. To go to service, you press Windows button, type down service, and open this app. You want to go to the service called Windows Management Instrumentation. Look for this particular service and press stop to stop the service. Windows will tell you that it will make some program not work, and you will say yes because you will want to get rid of those files. After this service has been stopped, you go back to the WBEM repository and you delete all the files. All right. After you delete all the files, don't do anything else. Restart your PC. And I mean restart, don't shut down. Restart your PC. After you have restarted your PC, you can come back to this particular folder and see. You will see that five files has been restored. And by that point, your activation service should work. But how can you prove that you have fixed it? How can you prove that it works? You come to command prompt. Doesn't have to be administrator mode to check for this. Come to command prompt, type down slmgr, and then press enter. usually if that if the error 0x80041002 still be a problem, you will see another error. You will see that particular error show up here. But right now my system has been fixed, so when I type down SLMGR, it shows the invalid combination of command parameter error. If you see this, it means that SLMGR or license manager can connect to the activation server normally. And then if you see this kind of return to your SLMGR right now, you can proceed to reactivate your window or rearm your activation or whatever you do. Alright, and that's it. I hope these steps has fixed your problem. Have a good day.